Hello, basketball coaches and basketball players. My name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training, and today I'm going to show you some great baseline inbounds plays that work fantastic at the grade 12 level. So hello everyone, my name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training. On this channel, I show you basketball plays, drills, and skills. So if you like that stuff, hit that like button and subscribe. But anyways, today I'm going to show you some great baseline inbounds plays that you can run with your grade 12 or senior high school level basketball team. So these are baseline inbounds plays that are not super ridiculously advanced that you would normally see at the college or university level. You will see sometimes these plays be ran at that level, but generally speaking in the junior or senior level in high school, you will be seeing these quite often, and these are my favorite out of the plays at that level. So let's get down to the clipboard and let's check these out. Okay, so first in this first play, it's just a simple box. First, what we're going to have is player 2 popping out, and he's going to receive that pass. Next, what we will have is player 3 popping out as well, and we're going to be having player 5 cutting down towards this corner, setting a screen for player 4. Player 1 is going to pop out, player 2 is going to pass the ball to player 1, and player 4 is going to be using player 5 as a screen, and player 1 is going to be passing player 4 the ball for that layup. This is very simple, but generally speaking, a grade 6 or 7 team will not understand how to run this play unless you run it a lot during practice. So this is why I'm saying this is a great grade 12 basketball play. This play, however, still can work against a 2-3 zone as well, and let me show you what I mean. So against a 2-3 zone, what we're going to have is player 2 popping up just a bit higher. Instead of him going straight out exactly the same degree as the baseline, he's going to pop out at a 45 degree angle. That's going to give him separation from player 3 red. He's going to lob it over or pass to player 2. And then what's going to happen now, player 1 is going to pop out. Player 3 is now clearing out to then guard player 2. Player 5 has his head on a swivel, but we're going to have player 5 setting a screen for player 5 red. Player 2 is going to pass the ball over to player 2. Or player 1, I mean, and player 4 is then going to pop either this side or that side of player 5. Personally, I would pick this on the right side, or technically 4's left, because then he's staying away from player 4. Player 1 can then pass player 4, blue the ball in the key, and he can get himself a nice easy shot. Now here is another box inbounds play. We're going to have player 4 popping out. We're going to have player 1 popping out. This is going to be passing around the perimeter. He can take a dribble or two over. Meanwhile, while this is happening, we're going to have player 2 setting up a screen on this side of the key for player 3. Player 3 is going to pop either to the mid-range or 3-point line area while this ball is being passed around the perimeter, so that when player 5 passes to player 3, he's going to be jacking up that 3-point shot. Meanwhile, we have player 2 for rebounding on that side. We have player 1 who can cut down the middle of the key for the rebound there. And we have player 4 who can cut down the middle or the right side of the key there, so that we can have 3 players rebounding the ball so we can get those offensive rebounds. As you may know, I am all about those offensive rebounds. I always have at least 3 players on around the rim to grab those rebounds. Okay, so now what I call the S play. I've showed you this quite a few times on this website, but actually on this YouTube channel, but we're going to call S2 in this case. Normally we would call the first letter of the player's name. So if his name was Steve, then we would call it SS, and that would mean that player 2 is going to then cut in between players 4 and 5. They are then going to set a sandwich screen so that they catch his defender. He's going to pop out, and then player 1 is going to come down for the rebound. Player 3 is going to be then running in bounds. We have 4 players who can then grab the offensive rebound. Meanwhile, player 2, if he is our best player at shooting, or at least the best shooter on the court, he should have a good percentage chance of getting it in, considering he should be wide open. This play will only work against a man-to-man defense. Now, if you're still playing against a man-to-man defense, this is another play that's very similar, except we're running it a bit higher. Now, the idea behind this play is to have one of these two players, one of our better passers, to go in between players 2 and 4. It's going to be a sandwich screen. Player 3 is going to be open. Now, he could take that shot, but we have no rebounders unless these guys crash, in which case that could be an option. But what we are hoping for now, these guys are then going to be popping out towards the three-point line. Of course, by this time, player 3 is going to be then recovering. Player 5 is going to be running inbounds. And we now have either a lob over top to player 5, because now he has this whole side of the court open to get a left-handed layup. Or if he's able to battle player 5, he could get in front. And this is now an isolation in the post with the player who just inbounded the ball. Definitely another play that is very good at the high school level, especially if you have a killer center who is very good. And now in our last play, what I'm going to show you is a simple play where player 1 is going to set up a screen for player 2. Player 2 is going to pop out. He's going to receive that pass. Now at this time, we're going to then have player 3. He is going to run inbounds to the other side of the court. And we're going to be setting up. Now that player 2 red is fought through, we're going to have player 4 pop out to the wing as well. This is now going to shift the defense over to like this. We're going to have player 1 set a screen for player 1 red. Of course, player 2 could have shot that ball anyways. Player 5 is then going to go and do a high cut across using player 1 as a screen. Player 2 could pass him the ball for that shot as well. But because of this, this is collapsing the defense, where now player 3 blue can then pop up to the free throw line extended or higher. And from there, player 5 could pass out for the three-point shot. We then also now have a couple of rebounders who can grab that rebound as well. Now, I hope that these plays help your team. If they do, let us know in the comments below. And I will see you guys again tomorrow for another daily basketball video.